Hello everybody! Stare here, and it is Tuesday! Which is a weird day to stream, I know, but had other commitments tomorrow, so we made a little switcheroo there with the newly edited video and the live stream, and here we are with Slay the Spire. What did we happen to do last time? Well, just to make a big recap, we got to the end boss of Act 1, and I for some reason thought that it was the end boss of the entire game, which was, I don't know why I thought that, but I did. And we didn't get any further than the end boss, but we got a new character. I think we just can abandon. Which is the Silent, instead of the Ironclad. The Silent, a deadly huntress from the Foglands, eradicates foes with daggers and poison. Her relic at the start of each combat draw 2 additional cards. Wow, that's actually pretty good. I guess healing is also really good, but why don't we just jump straight into it? This is weird. I don't know what is happening. I've seen the screen a couple of times now, trying to get things started, but
greetings. At least confront the first boss.
What? What? Why is there a whale? A big whale-like creature in the spire? Enemies in your next 3 combats have 1 HP. Okay. Full screen is indeed. It's sort of like a trademark we have built up right now, isn't it? That we keep forgetting full screen. God, so stupid. So, more HP or 3 combats have 1 HP? I think this one is better, right?
Granted.
So, what? The legendary whale creature came and bestowed on us its favors? That was so weird. Let's take the middle one, I think. So they both have 1. Okay, let's see. We have strike, 6 damage. It's the normal one. Defend is also... Okay, we only have these. Strike and strike. Okay, add a card to your deck. Dagger spray. Deal 4 damage to all enemies twice. Why not just 8 damage? Blur, gain 5 block. Block is not removed at the start of your next turn. That's really good. Gain 5 block and do 2 cards. So block is not removed. So we keep every block that we have. That's really good. New upgrade. Oh, okay, like that. So of course, if you haven't figured out by now, Slay the Spire is a card game, a deck building card game where we have to go as far as we can. Roguelike, in the roguelike genre. Against the computer, against the spire. The big fish. As you make your way down a long corridor, you see a banana, a donut, and a box floating around. No, upon closer inspection, they're tied to strings coming from holes in the ceiling. I like how the floating is actually floating. There's a quiet cackling from above as you approach the objects. Heal 33 XP. Gain plus 5. Obtain a relic. And become cursed. Playable. Regret, at the end of your turn, lose HP equal to number of cards in your hand. That seems not good. Let's do the donut. You eat the donut, it really hits the spot. Your max HP is increased. Interesting. Twice is probably to negate some blocking first damage or something like that. That would actually make sense. Yes, indeed. Curl up, and they still don't only have 1 HP on button. Oh, we got another card here. Neutralize. Apply 3 damage. Deal 3 damage. Apply 1 weak. Alright. Might as well kill them off, though. And add a card. Next turn, gain energy. 5 damage for 0 energy. That's pretty good. Calculate game. Discard your hand, then draw that many cards. So if we can't use our hand... That's really good to cycle through. We don't exhaust the other cards. Exhaust is when you lose the card for the next turn or for the rest of the combat. I think that's super good actually. We could also combo it if we get other exhaust cards. There's a merchant here. We have 131 gold.
Welcome!
What? Oh, okay, like that. We had to press on him. Ew, look at his finger! Oh, that's bizarre and feels wrong. It looks so weird. Okay, never mind. To all enemies twice, 8 damage, draw a card. Draw a card, discard a card. That one is for sale. Apply 3 potion. Start of your turn, add a shift. What's a shift? Shifts are 0 cost attack cards with exhaust. Okay. Chrysalis. Shuffle 3 item skills into your draw pile. They cost 0 this combat and exhaust. Or madness. Reduce the cost of a random card. Yes, yes, I know. I mean, I have only played this for like 45 minutes, 40 minutes or something like that in my first video. So all of the cards are also new to me because we played with the Ironclad first time around. Reduce the cost of a random card in your hand by 0 or 2-0. I think we need some AoE. No refunds! Okay. Oh, we could also buy relics and potions and everything. Whenever you use a potion. Card removal. Remove a card from a deck. The cost of this service increases by 25. Okay. Interesting. I think that's all we want. Okay. This is so weird. Should we go to the unknown? Or should we go do some encounters? These are the last encounters we have where they only have 1 HP. So the route we can take. There's a merchant here, we don't need him. I think let's go to the unknown and see what happens. The cleric. A strange blue humanoid with a golden helm approaches you with a huge smile. Hello friend, I am cleric. He's not just the cleric, he is cleric. He's called cleric. Right. Are you interested in my services? The creature shouts loudly. Oh, he should have had it in all caps then. No. We are not. We don't need to heal and we don't want the card removed. You don't trust this cleric, so you leave. This cleric. Alright. Well, interesting. The jaw worm. Ain't got nothing on us. Survivor, gain 8 block, discard a card. Ooh. This hero here feels very gambly. Gain 2 dexterity. What's dexterity? Okay, choose a card. Expertise. Draw a card until you have 6 in your hand. But we already draw 2. Oh, that might not be bad. Poison. Apply 3 poison. Deal 4 damage. Get another one. Why would you want to remove a card? I think if we had chosen the relic at the banana donut box thingy, we would have gotten a card called Regret, and that card could actually have been removed. So I think there are bad cards as well, which is interesting. We don't really want the merchant, do we? No, we wanna... Oh, we want a chest! A pen nip. Every 10th attack you play deals double damage. 10th attack. Ah, okay. I was about to say that would make like a really long fight, but if we attack 3 times, 4 times in a row, we would actually gain this pretty fast. I don't want to skip the relic. But it didn't say remove a bad card, it just said remove a card. I'm so confused. Oh, I read that as you choose to remove which card you want to be removed, but I don't actually know. Maybe it's just a random card. Maybe we should try that at one point. Wow, all of these unknowns haven't been creatures yet. You come across a dead adventurer on the floor. His pants have been stolen. No. Also, he looks to have been eviscerated and chopped by giant claws. He doesn't look eviscerated and chopped. Though his possessions are still intact, you are in no mind to find out what happened here. 25% of monsters return. Let's do that! Couldn't find anything. Oh. Find loot, 50% monsters return. Ah, 50% chance that monsters return. Some of the wording in this game are a little bit weird. I mean... Okay, we found something! Fossil or Helix, prevent the first time you would lose HP in each combat. Very good. Find another loot. Yes, continue with it. Ah, oh, it was the Lagavulin while searching the adventurer. You're caught off guard. Wasn't really caught off guard, were we? I don't think so. So this is going to do something to us next time. Five block. Discard your hand and draw that red card. We might as well just... Yeah, there we go. End turn. It's not going to attack us next turn, it's just gonna do some negative effect. Minus strength, minus block. Okay. Next time it's gonna hit us for 18. We definitely need to defend. Gain 4 block seems like a good idea. We're going to get hit by 1 week. And there we go. Okay, some actual combat. Finally, I guess. It's funny, this Niao's Lament, this one that said all of your first 3 combats enemies are set to 0, it's not gone. I wonder if we can like refresh it. Wait, why didn't he... I'm confused. Why didn't we take any damage? We had 10 block, didn't we? Yes. 7 block. Oh, choose a card. Okay. This one's still better, so... Discard that card. He's gonna hit us. 4, 3, ow. Oh, maybe it was because he had weak, actually. Oh, yeah, of course. Wasn't it the fossil, the first? Oh, the first health tree. Yes, exactly. It was the fossil. Wow, I forgot about that already. Block is not removed. Okay, apply weak. So now it's weak. Next time it deals 25% less damage. Okay. Since it's applying weak to us, we might as well do that. We want to exhaust. No, we don't. We want to use this one. And then end the turn. Strength down. Ow. Oh no. Defense down. Block. Oh, weak doesn't count for this. Oh, it counted for that turn. Oh, that sucks. That sucks like a lot. Ooh, next time we maybe get to deal double damage. Nice. Ow. So, my experience from the first playthrough, I guess the first video that we did, is that if we can, we should really try to defend all that is possible. Discard a card. Discard this one. Because we want to have as much health when we get to like big bosses. And maybe upgrade at... at fires. Blur. Oh, this is good. Because we gain block that is not removed. I guess. No, we know it's going to. I might as well. We know that it's not going to hit us, so we have next turn we have to start with 9 block, which is really good. It does. Just steal a lot of damage though. Okay, so this one that hit for 9. Oh, I misread. I thought it. Oh, every 10th attack. I don't know why. I thought it would be every 11th attack. Huh. Oh well. Dexterity improves block gain from cards. So. Might as well do that and that. Okay. Wow, we are taking a beating from this. Really heavy beating. It's going to I wonder if we're going to die already. That's interesting. Deal 1 damage. Oh my god. Let's drink this one and gain some block and try to calculate gamble. Okay. So gain armor and attack. Oh god damn it. I don't know. I'm a little bit worried that we're not gonna be able to kill this, actually. Because we're so weak? But it hits so freaking hard. See, this one deals no damage at all. Oh my god, we might die. I think we might die. Card this one. This is so bad. Okay, the Ironclad was a little bit easier to play. I don't know, not sure why. Maybe it's because I was just so aggressive. And with this one we should be aggressive though. Yeah, we really failed on the strategy. Damn it. -5? Really? Yeah, we're dead! This was the worst start I have ever seen. Oh my god, can we abandon run? Yeah, don't mind. Let's just die. God damn. That was super bad. So we know the strategy of against the Lagavulin, it's just to attack. Before it does the negative effect. As much as we can. Apply weak. That one, and this one. And, oh, we actually have no. Never mind. Damn, wow, that was super bad. Oh, new character. I feel like we're going to play with this, the silent one, before the break, and maybe after the break use the defect. Okay, that seems weird. Let's try another one. Okay.
Oh, greetings!
It's the whale!
Reach the boss, receive more blessing.
Enemies in the next 3 combats have +1 HP. Yeah, I guess. I guess we'll do that again. Granted. So 3 combats. Oh, maybe we start with this. It would ensure that we could actually, if none of these two are combats. Oh, don't worry, you're still learning. You'll get there. Oh you. I just felt like I did so well on my first run that I should be able to reach the boss again. But we didn't. Anyway, what I wanted to say was, if these two unknowns are not bosses, not enemies, we'll actually get all the way here with this Neo's Lament and meet a real boss here. So that's... No, that was one him. Okay, maybe not. Yeah, maybe not. Holy smokes. We do start with quite a lot of cards. At the start of each combat, though. So it's not each turn. It's very interesting. Applies deal 7 damage by 1 week. Reflex! If this card is discarded from your hand, draw one card. It's actually not bad. We had some discard cards. But nah, take it, Sucker Punch. We need damage. We saw last time what not taking damage did to us. You fall into a puddle. It's made of slime goop. No, not slime goop. Frantically. You claw yourself out over several minutes as you feel the goop starting to burn. You can feel goop in your ears, goop in your nose, goop everywhere. Climbing out, you notice that some of your gold is missing. Looking back to the puddle, you see your missing coins combined with gold from unfortunate adventurers mixed together in the puddle. Oh man. So lose 11 and gain 75 coins. Let's do that! Feeling the sting of the goop as the prolonged exposure starts to melt away at your skin. Oh, ew. You manage to fish out the gold. Alright. I did that because we actually gain like 2, 3 and then this one, so we could heal up here though. I thought that was pretty smart. Good way to gain gold, right? I like this third three encounters. First three encounters with one health, it really makes the a good strategy, even more good strategy in where you place your journey. Acrobatics, draw three cards, discard one card. So we can actually draw four cards if we discard. No, we didn't take the reflex one. Ah, damn it. Eviscerate, cost one less energy for each card discarded this turn, deals 6 damage. Okay, next turn, gain 2. Acrobatics. Let's try the gain energy one. It's like, what's it called? In Hearthstone, the druid one, druid card. I don't remember. Oh! A strange blue humanoid. It's cleric. You know what, cleric? You can heal us. A warm golden light envelops your body and dissipates. The creature grins. Cleric, best healer. Have a good day. Oh, he's actually really sweet, cleric. Now we may be able to upgrade. Oh yeah, we are able to upgrade a card because this one will die and not take any damage. Nice. Explosive potion. Ooh, deal 10 damage to all creatures. We could have used that. Draw a card, discard a card. Discard your hand. I didn't really feel like this was a great card. I mean, I can see the potential of it. But I think we just need to get as far as possible. Another sucker punch. Okay, elite or treasure? Let's do the treasure one. And upgrade a card. What happens if we upgrade this one? Oh, gain 3. Wow, we can do a lot then. Let's do that. Yeah. Wow. Okay, I gotta comment on it again. The perspective on this is so bad. It's so bad. All right. Actually, the real battle is about to start here. Okay, they're going to curl up and gain a lot of block. If we do the sucker punch on this one, we can actually kill it. I think do the outmaneuver one. And then... yeah, then kill it straight up. Oh, it didn't die. Why didn't it die? Upon receiving 6 damage... gain 6 block. Oh my god, that sucks! Apply weak. Might as well apply it to that one, right? Okay, so we're gonna take some damage. Damn it. That was a miscalculation on my part. I thought it would die. Stupid louses. I guess we should have damaged all of them. Well, we may be able to defend. Let's do that. It's going to do a negative effect on us. Damn. Spitbait. We are weakened. Oh, minus 2. Attack deals... oh, 25% less damage for 2 turns. That sucks. Oh, that really sucks. I want weak. Going to use a buff, so we don't actually need to kill that. This is 9. Discard card. Buy a weak one. Almost kill it. There we go. Just discard that one. It's fine. It's fine! A buff. Plus 3 attack. Nice. And now we should be able to kill them, right? All of them. Yes. Okay, we actually won a fair and square combat. Who would have thought? Ghost in a jar, gain 1 intangible. What's intangible? Reduce all damage taken and HP loss to 1. Oh, that's crazy good. Deal 8 damage. Next turn, gain an energy. There are no drawbacks to this card. Why is it so good? Quick slash. Deal 8 damage. Draw 1 card. Let's get the energy one. Okay. It's a looter. 3 thievery. Oh. Steals 15 gold whenever it attacks. Really? Oh. So outmaneuver, we actually had too many cards in our hand. Not enough card in our hand to use all the energy from outmaneuver. I'm thinking flying kick and 2 of these so we don't take damage. And he's gonna grab 15. Coins? What the fudge? That's so mean. Apply 1 weak. Defend. Oh, we can do everything here. Okay, that was pretty good. Though we do lose another coin. What was the other? Deal 10 damage. Okay, so we couldn't actually do that yet. That's also to all enemies, so that's a really good... that's really, really good, what's it called? It is a really good AoE. Why? Me and words, I swear to God. Me and words. So bad. One. Yeah, we can kill him. Yes. You don't take any more coin from us! Ah, we get them back. Great. Add a card to a deck. Okay. Crippling Cloud. Apply 4 poison and 2 weak to all enemies. What is poison? Lose HP at the start of the turn. Each turn, poison is reduced by 1. How much HP do they lose? Deal 20 damage. Whenever you play a card this turn, the enemy loses 3 HP. Oh, that's super good with like outmaneuver and flying knee. Let's take that card. Okay, treasure or treasure? Uh, I'm gonna take this treasure because we can potentially use. We can heal at one campfire and upgrade at another campfire. Ornamental fan. Every time you play three attacks in a single turn, gain four block. Not bad, not bad. Campfire. So let's see, rest, that's 21 HP. Okay. I think if we smith now and then rest next time, we might lose a little bit in the next fight. Then we gain more value out of the resting. Huh? Huh? I'm thinking about stuff. So. Ooh. 5 HP. That's really good. What about this one? 11. This is just more damage. More block. That's just flat out more damage. And more damage too weak. Let's do the choke one. Yeah. Bing, bing, bing. Proceed. The split. Whenever its HP is at or below 50%, will split into two smaller slimes with acid slime L's current HP. Oh. Okay. Okay, that's interesting. So, deal damage. I guess we will defend as much as we can here. Okay, I heard a little bit. Oh yeah, we're energized. Outmaneuver next time. Oh, could have used choke there. Could have used choke the next turn so we could play a lot of cards. You know what, just choke it. My weak defend and another punch. More weak. Oh, it's going to do something unknown. It's not attacking though, so it was actually. I don't know if it was just exactly great that we gained block. It wasn't exactly great, no. Choke whenever you play a card this turn. Wow, that really. That really took its took a toll on it. And then because so it spent a whole turn doing that. Okay. Gain 8 block. Apply weak. So this one. Yes, like this, discard that card, and... Oh, that was dumb. Oh, no, it's not going to do anything, is it? Isn't it going to split? Oh, okay, this one isn't going to split. Okay, so that was actually fine. We are exhausted. What? Did he just give us a card? A really bad card? Why did he do that? This one intends to... With a negative effect on you, on us. Survivor. So if we do this, discard a block card, we can kill it. Well, that doesn't make any sense to kill that one because we don't take damage from it. We lose our block then. It is gonna. Oh, that's the negative effect it's gonna give us. Okay. Okay. Flying knee. Flying knee 6. 5, 4. Okay, we almost... maybe we should have used defend instead, actually. Took a little bit of damage. Yeah, we definitely need to heal at the resting place. Oh, the outmaneuver first here. Damn. Removed until the end of combat. So we have to play it in order to get rid of it. Okay. That makes sense, I guess. gold and add a card. Apply poison and 2 weak to all enemies. That's really good. Apply 5 poison. Crippling cloud. Okay. And now we can heal. Almost to full health. Pretty nice. And then there's the elite here. Oh, it's a Lagavulin. Okay, so we can just... we can just smack it as it is asleep. It's gonna wake up. This one, and then... I guess poison it? Right? Poison. Lose 4 HP. Okay, so that's like 16. Wow. It's actually really good. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that card. Okay, it is the... it's stunned though? No, it wasn't stunned. Need to weaken it. And... it's the revenge, the grudge match against the Lagavulin. That was what I wanted to say. We can use all our cards. Sweet. Oh, we don't take any damage from it because it's weak and everything. Okay. And remember, we need to really, really kill it. Fast. I wish I had outmaneuver though. Choke. And Sunder Punch. It's gonna deal 13 damage. I guess that's fine. 12, fine. Okay, we outmaneuver now. 1 week. Outmaneuver. Strike it. And this one. Ah, oh, we should have used 2 Sucker Punches. Damn it, we. We are still learning, okay? We're still learning. That's gonna be my excuse. Ah, I was learning! It's got a card. Oh, we don't have to discard a card if we go something like this. Yeah. 15. Oh, yeah. Now. Ah, so... so sad. Might as well do this one first, and then this one. So it's not poisoned anymore. It's gonna hit us a 13. Yeah. I guess that's okay. Well, we got it. Otherwise, what was it going to hit us for? 5 or something? 8? At the end of your turn, without block, gain 6 block. Oh, pretty good, really. Gain 12 block. That's a pretty good block potion. Add a card. Gain 5 block, draw 2 cards. Innate. Start each combat with this card in your hand. Deal 11 damage. Or apply 5 points. This is 20 damage over 5 turns. We start with this. So we start with 11 damage straight up. I think deadly poison. I thought that was pretty good. Let's do the unknown because we don't want to lose any more HP. Yeah, GG easy. Totally easy. The serpent. You walk into a room and find a large hole in the ground. As you approach the hole, an enormous serpent creature appears from within.
Ho ho. Hello, hello. What have we got here? Hello, adventurer. I ask you a simple question. The most fulfilling of lives is that in which you can buy anything. Do you agree?
So this is a curse. Wow, that's really bad. So we can gain 175 gold and then become cursed, which means we keep getting stacking up weeks. We saw how badly that went with the Lagavulin each turn. We don't have a way of actually getting rid of that. So I guess we'll disagree with the serpent. The serpent stares at you with a look of extreme disappointment. I love these random encounters. It's so funny. Okay, we need to rest, right? Gain 21 HP. Yeah. Okay. We are at the Guardian. Oh, not the Guardian necessarily. But it wasn't the Guardian. Hexaghost. The interesting thing. The final boss of Act 1. Which is different from the last time. So, I guess we'll just choke it and flying knee it. And damn it, we should have used poison. Oh my god, that was bad. So what does it do? Aggressive 5 damage 6 times. Okay, this one weakens it. So 3 damage for 6. Ow. How much is that? 3 times 6. That's 18. I don't want to use the poison, the potion right now. Weakness wear off. Only deals 6, but it also negatively affects us. Well, we can weaken it more. We can weaken it even more, and we can plug, and we can survive. Survivor, and don't take any damage there. Unplayable? What was that? Oh, what was that card? Okay, we need to apply the potion here. So that one is weak for another turn. It's going to 3 times 2, so that's 6 damage. And potion or survivor? Potion or survivor? A poison, not potion. 10 damage. I think survivor, and then discard a strike card. Yeah, I think that's the best. the poison. Why? I am jumbling around the words potion and poison, and I don't know why. That mean two very different things. So, my weak one. It's gonna give us another of those burn cards. I guess we might as well have another one. I'll take 2 damage. Oh, that sucks. So what are you going to do? Intend to block and use buff. Okay. So we're just gonna deal all the damage that we can. Okay. Not really any use in taking those, right? Okay, burn on play, but at the end of your turn take 2 damage. That sucks! That sucks so bad. My weak. Block, my block. Strike it. We take 2 damage. Gosh, these art assets really annoy me. Oh, can you move the mic down a bit? Oh, sorry. Is that better? Yeah, I tend to lean forward into it. The art asset, yeah, the art is, it could have been better, right? But it's really compelling gameplay, I think. Really compelling gameplay. So 8 damage. Apply weak, that's only 6 then. Sucker punch. Move it. Gain 5. Okay, we might actually take down the guardian. Yay! Not a guardian, the hex, the act one boss, right? Okay. So now he deals that 3 times 6. So that's a lot. We have, well, we can do everything. Not use that first. Strike, strike, and strike. 12. And that's 18. 10 damage. Or end the turn. I think we can take a little bit more punishing. This is one of the Oh god. Oh, that applied so much burn! Oh, no. 4 damage. Damn it. This is one of the first games I've seen where the art is the weakest point and the gameplay is good. It's usually reversed. Yeah, that's true. Okay, so it's gonna deal quite a lot of damage. Choke it. Poison it. And then drink this to gain block. We take 10 damage. Damn it, that burn sucks so much. We should have poisoned him a long time ago. Flying knee, definitely. Gain 1 all damage taken and HP loss. So 7 times 2. Defend. This is 14, 18. Let's try to drink this intangible. So that was 1 damage. Ah. Okay. Should I have used that defend? We are still learning. Discard a card. We can discard burn, can we? Oh. Yeah, we did discard it. Ha! Interesting. Okay. Wow, that's so good then. So very good. Defensive burn. Oof. Those sucks. Sucks so bad. Throw it! Might as well deal 10 damage. It's going to inflame us. Okay. It's going to inflame itself. So it deals so much more damage. High weak. Flying knee kick. And strike it. We take 12 damage. Ow. Hurts so much. Okay. Apply weak. Apply another weak. Yes. Crippling. And strike it. And because if you end your turn without block. Oh, we do have block though. Because of this. Oh, they actually. These two relics actually don't work very well together, do they? Can you turn down the music a bit? Oh, yes, we can. Maybe here? Is that better? Let's see. Is that better? I hope so. I don't hope it's too much because that it does add to the experience, right? Ugh, so many burns. 12 damage. So 4 times 6. Begin this one. Poison. This is better. Defend. Poison. Block. Now we should gain 6 block. Which means we don't take. No. No, if we... Oh, I failed. So close. I don't think we could have done anything else. That was close! Man, it's not bad music, but it's still kind of repetitive and, yeah, loud. Okay. Oh, man! We were so close to doing the Guardian one. That's not a Guardian. I don't know why I keep saying it. It was the final boss of the act. Okay. Let's have a break. Next time, we're gonna do the defect and see where we can go from there. Okay? So, break time. 5 minutes. I'm gonna get some cake. And I urge you to, too. And let's see if we can take down that goddamn final boss of the first act. 5 minutes.